Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. In today's video, we're going to be talking about potential. Should you date a man that has potential? Come on, we've all heard it. You really like a guy, but he's just not quite the full package. And then you start to question yourself, am I being superficial? Am I being shallow? Maybe I'll give him a chance. So you give him a chance and it just ends up grinding your nut, frustrating the living daylights out of you because he is not living up to your idea of a man, or vice versa if you're a guy watching. And I just want to let you guys know that you are not being mean if you want to see a glimpse of that guy's potential right before you even start dating, okay? Just a disclaimer, I'm not talking about someone who is married, who's already chosen someone. I'm talking about in the dating process. Should you date a guy that has potential? Okay, so I think I have to first start off by saying, recognizing that somebody has potential is great, but it is just not enough. You cannot build your life, your future on what he could be. You must build your present and future on what he's already showing you now. And sure, do people grow? Yes. Do people change? Yes. Do people evolve? Yes. But you can kind of get an idea of who somebody is by looking at where they're at now, talking about the sacrifices that they've had to make to get here, talking about their past. Sometimes it's possible to see who a person is by looking at where they are now. Not always, there's always an exception to the rule, but most of the time it's always easy to see who a person is by what they're currently presenting in front of you. And let me be clear, there's always exceptions to this rule. My friend met her now husband when he didn't have a dime. I mean, he only had probably £50 in his account, and that wasn't always the case, but he was going through a rough time. I'm not talking about meeting someone that is currently going through a bad time. Life happens to all of us. One minute you're up, next minute you're down. Sometimes life is just circumstantial. So I'm not talking to someone that you meet that is now currently out of a job. I'm talking about someone that can't keep a job, let alone just being out of a job. So I think when you're looking at somebody and you're seeing if they have potential, you must look at their track record. My friend, he was once up, but she met him when he was going through a hard time. I am not talking about hard time people, okay? I'm talking about people that have a pattern of behavior that is counterproductive to what you want in a man. It's okay, ladies, to have standards. I have to say this because, yes, a lot of people that watch my channel do have standards, but a lot of women in the world don't have standards. A lot of women will just be happy to have a man, whether he's got a job, whether he's got any plans for the future, whether he is reliable, they don't care. They just want a man. And that somebody is somebody that has very little standards. But I hope I'm talking to women who have standards or want better for their lives. And a lot of men will try and pass it off as, oh, girls are being superficial. I want a girl that will ride or die for me. I want a girl that can hold me down. Like Keisha Kore held Gucci Mane down when he went to prison. No. Our mothers taught us better. We want more for ourselves. And just because it worked for her, just because it worked for Keisha in that case, does not mean that she is the rule. There are always exceptions to every rule. And a lot of guys were trying to defend their point, like to say, oh, but Michelle Obama was with Barack before he was the president of the United States. The difference between Barack and your bum ass is that he was always making steps towards becoming president of the United States. And even if he didn't become the president, he would have got close, okay? He not only had potential, but he had ambition. Ambition is what are you doing now to get to your end result, okay? There is a difference between a man that is a dreamer and a man that has ambition. And the difference is, what are they doing? Talking about, oh, one day I'm gonna be a millionaire. One day I'm gonna own a business. One day I'm going to get a degree. One day I'm gonna become a preacher. One day I'm fixing to. One day I'm finna to. One day! What are you doing? Today! You ain't doing squat diddly what, okay? You ain't doing nada to progress. And so I should come in and I should take you and say, oh, you've got potential. You ain't got a job right now. Haven't had a job for 6 months. Haven't had a job for a year and a half, but yeah, one day he's gonna get a job and we're gonna have this beautiful house. And I'm sorry, that does not work for us, okay? Especially as 21st century women, a lot of men want us to feel bad about having stability. Stability, stability, stability. One thing that I asked God for, one thing that I desired in my potential spouse, my potential husband, my potential partner, that was stable. Not only financially stable, which is very important, but emotionally stable. A lot of these men want you to feel like you're asking for the moon and back because you want stability, okay? As women, we need stability because we are emotional creatures. If we don't feel safe, if we don't feel secure, we are going to feel out of control, right? You can't take a woman from her father's house where she had stability and bring her into a world that is unsafe, into a world that hasn't got walls, into a world that doesn't have protection. It is not fair. You wouldn't want it for your own daughter. You wouldn't want it for your sister. So don't make a woman feel bad because she wants stability. And woman, do not feel bad because you're looking for a man that is stable, okay? One of my things on my list was financially stable, okay? And that does not mean he gotta be a millionaire. He gotta be financially stable. He gotta have savings. He's gotta have money put away for a rainy day. He has to be financially literate. He needs to understand money. He needs to be a good spender, a good saver. He needs to be able to get knowledge. He needs to be able to be open to counsel and advice. All of these things make up a financially stable person, okay? Let's talk for a second about emotional stability, okay? This may be a touchy subject, okay? But I think if you have something, you shouldn't be made to feel bad if you're looking for that same thing in somebody else, okay? It doesn't mean that you're refusing to change. It doesn't mean you're refusing to be flexible. It just means you want what you want. And most of us, we know what we need. It's not even a want. It's like, I need someone that's emotionally stable because I can't with someone that is just going to be like this. And it's not just about mental health. They could be emotionally unavailable. Somebody with an anger issue. Someone that you can't even communicate with. You can't even tell them how you're feeling. You can't tell them when they're wrong. Just someone that is pig-headed, right? You need someone that is emotionally stable. You can't wait for them to become emotionally stable. When you're in a dating process, you need to look for someone that is already emotionally stable. And let me be clear, who a person is now isn't all that they're going to become. But you have to be okay with the person that you're seeing in front of you, like they'll never change. You gotta love somebody like they will never change, right? You gotta fully accept someone for who they are right now. I fully accept my boyfriend for who he is now. Does he have potential to be more? Yes. And I'm gonna cheer him on and I'm gonna celebrate him and I'm excited for that potential. But I'm okay with him right now. And that's what I've gotta build my life on. That's what you gotta build your life on. Can you accept this person? Because if you don't accept someone, you're steady going to be waiting for them to change. And that is no way to live. You would not want to be with someone, be in a committed relationship with someone who is waiting for you to change. How are you going to feel? You're going to feel like this person does not accept me for who I am. The reality of life is you can't gamble. You have to build your life upon what you know now. And I have to say, like I said before, there's an exception and there's a rule. People who change are rare, which is why you have to accept someone for who they are now. If you want children and you get with a guy that does not want children, you cannot hope that this guy changes, because he's probably hoping the same thing about you. He's probably hoping that you will just stop bothering him and let him live his childless life. You really have to accept someone for who they are now. And I know it's hard when you meet someone that you really, 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 really like and you feel like they check all the boxes but the important ones that you want checked. And those important ones that you need checked, if you get with them, those things are going to be the very reason why you leave. The red flags that you ignore in the beginning is going to be the reason you leave in the end. Do not ignore your gut feeling. Do not ignore your gripe. Some things are deal breakers, and check out my video if you haven't seen it. Some things are just deal breakers, okay? Some things you just can't look past. Let's say religion, for one. If you are a practicing Christian or vice versa, if you're a practicing Christian, you believe in Jesus, you believe in the Bible, you believe that God gave his only son, and you marry a man or you get with a man that is a Muslim, can he change? Could he convert? Yes, he can. But what is he right now? What if he doesn't? You guys are unequally yoked. You guys do not match. And what we sometimes have a tendency to do is try to make people fit what we want them to fit. It's just plain selfish. It's just plain selfish. Accept the person for who they are now. And when it comes to relationship, you have to find your match, okay? It's about finding a good match. It's not finding someone that's kind of a match, but you like them to change a little bit before they become a match. No, you meet someone that is a match for you. You meet someone that has the same morals, same interests, same goals in life. You've got to be a match. You can't hope or want them to change. You got to accept them for who they are. I feel like guys don't settle for potential. No guy is going to marry you if they can't visually see now who you are. Because who you are now to men is who you're going to be, okay? That's obviously a generalization. Not all men care. But to generally, to men, men are very logical. If she's orange, she's orange, okay? Not she's orange, but I want her to be yellow. Maybe she'll change to yellow. No, she's orange. She looks orange. She talks about orange. She's orange, okay? She's yellow. She looks yellow. She talks yellow. She thinks yellow. She's a lemon. It just is what it is. Guys really, really, really settle for potential. Point blank, period. So if a man is not on your level, he's just not on your level. Even my boyfriend hates when I talk like that. Like, if he's not on your level, he's not on your level. You are the prize. Like, he hates when I talk like that. Anyway, it's true. If a guy is not on your level, he's not on your level. And you can't make him or force him to be on your level. I feel like some people are just not a match at the core. But a lot of women will just ignore that. Oh, yeah, maybe like he'll change. He says to me that since I've been dating you, you have inspired me to change.
You've inspired me to want to read more books. You've inspired me to want to go to university. You've inspired me.
And we ladies, we get a sense of joy. Like, yeah, I helped him. I helped him. Yes, he's inspired by me. But how long do you want to be the helper? Not in that sense, because God's called women to be a helper. How long do you want to have to be his mum? How long do you want to be his support? Who's going to be your support? If you're constantly supporting this man, who's going to be your support? We really got to think about this. When we're making decisions, we can't make rash decisions. I'm assuming most of you want to get married. So when we're making dating choices, we need to think about the future, okay? If you are on two different pages, your children are going to be on two different pages. The beauty of two people coming together in agreement is the power of unity, the power of oneness. If you're going here, he's going here, you're going to have conflicts. Relationships are hard enough as they are. You must be with someone is on your level, at least fundamentally, at least what you think is important. I can't tell you what I would choose in a man. And that's the thing, a lot of women want to advise other women. No, stay with him. No, be patient with him. No, me and you don't have the same grace. Me and you don't have the same patience. And that's one thing as well I want to say, and I want to really reiterate. If you meet a guy and he isn't where you want him to be, but you really, and I mean on a spiritual level, you see where he's going. You see that maybe he doesn't have a job right now, but you see him being the owner of a Fortune 500 company, $1 million business. Like, you can see him. You can literally see that person. Like, you have so much belief in them. You probably have more faith in them than they have in themselves, but you can see the vision and you can see yourself being a part of that. If you see the vision, then you go ahead. And I always say this, sometimes some people just aren't for you. I know I come into contact with guys that they have potential and they will make another woman very, very happy, and that other woman will really be there to support them. I don't have the grace for it. I don't have the grace to wait for you. I don't even have the grace to quote and grow together. Like, no. And it may seem shallow, but these are my standards. These are what I want. So never let anyone make you feel bad for wanting what you want. And that's what I want to say. Never let anyone make you feel bad for wanting what you want. And I guess that's all I really, really want to say. Like, don't try to change people. Accept them for who they are or let them go. People rarely change. Who they are right now is who they're going to be, with an exception of growth and change. The change may be small though. I keep saying this. This bottle is not going to become an iPhone. It's not going to change. I may be able to get it more rounded again. I may be able to crush it. It may change form, but it's always going to be a bottle of water. It's not going to miraculously change into an iPhone. They're two different natures, created for two different purposes. That's all I want to say, because I know there's a lot of girls out there that they may be dating someone and you know in your heart, this person isn't it. They're not your match. They're not your equal. But you feel bad because they have everything else that you want. Do I believe that someone has to have the complete full package? No, but they've got to have what you need, your fundamentals, what's important to you, what's going to make you feel safe. And so I hope you guys enjoy this video. Please share it with whoever will see it. If you want me to be your life coach, please click the link below and sign up to my mailing list. Until next time, stay safe. Love you guys.